University, and our topic is bioinformatics in molecular anthropology. The outline of our project is, first we're going to talk about the purpose, the goal, then what mitochondrial DNA is, what primates we use, the Python language, our program results, the importance of studying DNA, the conclusion, future work, and our conclusion. So what is bioinformatics? Bioinformatics is the study of biology mixed with computer science. Because of the advancements of technology, we now can use computers to do all the work of analyzing and comparing data with each other, and this is very useless. I mean, useful, not useless. useful in studying evolution in our project.
The purpose is to find the region of mitochondrial DNA, which we'll talk about later, with the most variation. Also, to learn both Python and use scripts to generate different programs to compare different. So, importance of mitochondrial DNA. We use mitochondrial DNA rather than nuclear DNA because it's more clear in terms of evolution. Because with mitochondrial DNA, you just pass down from different your mother rather than mixing with the father and the mother. They get a more clear lineage between different primates, so that's why we use mitochondria.
Yeah, and there's also DNA found in the nucleus, but mitochondrial DNA has a very small amount of DNA in it, and it's very useful because, as she said, it's only maternally inherited, so we can easily study genes and DNA. It's not messed up like.
Yeah, this is the mitochondria, and as she said, it's more smaller. It has about 16,000 bases pairs. Well, the nucleic DNA has millions. So we have broken up into three different groups. I did cataract, consisted of over monkeys, apes, humans, chimpanzees, etc.
Platyrines. It consists of monkeys in Central and South America.
And there was another group that did short sarai, but they're not here. But there are also reviewers and lawyers.
This is an example of how, when we sent the genes through the computer program, how it output the differences to us. It would more easily show us where the genes are varied.
I really can't go through everything, but it's a really simple we have variables, we give a command, and it just does something. It's a wild and very simple. So,
okay, these are the inexpensive laptops Dr. Todd was talking about. They're about $300. We did all of our work last summer on them. We used Ubuntu Linux, and through Python, we did, through this computer, we would run Python. And it was very fast, it was very easy. It was very fast, it was very easy, and we compared a lot of base pairs.
In terms of time, because it's small, it takes us a computer. Sometimes the program will take us 24 hours to run, at times 3 hours. So, I mean, if we were to utilize a large computer, say that, it would take about 5 minutes. We use it, we can. So, it's great thing to do for the first time. So, this is the program in action. This is it just running through different primates. As you can see, it's just comparing whatever primate that comes up. So, this is some of the data we have, and there's a lot of data. And what this is showing is the first one is 5,000, and that means it's looking at 5,000 immigrants present at a time. And this one is 500, so what you might notice is the 500 has a lot more variation, a lot more loops compared to the 5,000. And this is because that when you look at the smaller set of DNA, you notice more differences. While when you look at it as a whole, we're so much like that you're not going to find as much in the very different places.
So, what's the importance of studying DNA? As we all said before, we want to know where we're from, who we're related to. DNA helps us understand diseases, as we said before, but during our project, we compared to specific genes of different species, and we wanted to see how relative each of the species were to each other.
Yeah, and when you study DNA, there's, like you said, different patterns of the part of the DNA to inevitably map that evolutionary process.
Okay. Conclusion, we really didn't have a conclusion from last year. What we explored is that technology is advancing. We can use these laptops to help us understand more information about how important DNA plays a role in understanding evolution.
So we both are back at NYU this summer. So we're going to, again, work with Python. We're going to utilize Python. So we're going to take a lot of small programs and just combine them together to make one more program. It'll be much quicker and hope to bring that evolution to the
we would like to acknowledge Dr. Todd, our co-mentor Christina Burke, the Harlem Children's Society and staff, and you guys for listening.